Welcome back to Devices Setup channel again, and today we will learn how to set up any Netgear extender model using mywifiext.net login URL. So I know you all might have tried using mywifiext.net into the browser but with no success. Good news, after watching this video, your extender will definitely start working and will be set up in just few minutes. So let's start the process. So irrespective of which Netgear extender model you are using, this video works for all. Also, before we try this, make sure your router should be having a working internet. Moreover, disconnect any Ethernet cable connected to the extender. So first and foremost, plug your extender into any wall outlet and wait for its power LED to get stable. Now, we need to reset the Wi-Fi extender. You will find a small reset hole at the side or back of your extender depending upon its model number. For example, Netgear EX2700 has reset hole at the bottom, whereas Netgear extender 7300 has reset hole on the sides. So you need to press the reset hole with a paper clip or anything pointed for around 10 seconds while the extender is still plugged into the wall. You will see changes on the lights of the extender, like blinking, etc. Also, while you are holding a paper clip inside the reset hole, make sure the extender should be plugged into the wall. Now, wait for at least 2 minutes and let the lights on the extender get stable. Once the power light is stable again, grab any of your cell phone or computer. Now you will need to go to the Wi-Fi list on your phone or computer. So on your phone, you can go to the settings and then to Wi-Fi to check the Wi-Fi list. And on your Windows and Mac system, you simply just need to click on Wi-Fi icon showing up on the lower right hand side or upper right hand side of your screen respectively. There you will find Netgear_ext network name showing up. Connect to it. Don't worry when it says no internet. Once connected, the Netgear new extender setup window should pop up automatically. If it doesn't, then open any browser on the very same device. Now in the URL or address bar, type mywifiext.net and hit enter. It should bring Netgear new extender setup page for you. And if it doesn't, then try mywifiext.com or try mywifiext.local if you are a Mac user. Try using Netgear extender default IP address, that is 192.168.1.250, and hit enter. Also, be very sure to type this only into the URL of the browser. If you type it into the search bar, then this won't bring the extender's login page. It will show you some third-party websites who are using the similar URL as mywifiext.net. And when you click on it and talk to them, they will charge you money. So be aware of this. I have made separate video about this Netgear scam. You should definitely check that too. Plus, share it with your friends and family and save them too from this scam. Also, if it doesn't bring the Netgear login page, then kindly check if your phone or computer is still connected or not to the Netgear_ext network name in the Wi-Fi list. Taking all these measures should bring Netgear new extender setup page for you. On the setup page, follow the on-screen instruction to complete the setup. Like first, it will ask you to create an account, and later it will ask you to select the network name that you want to extend. So there, you simply just need to select your router's network name and type its password for confirmation and hit save or next. After the setup, by default, the Netgear extender will come up as your home network name _ext at the end in your Wi-Fi list. You can connect your devices to it by tapping onto that network name and typing the same password as your router. So this is how you can set up your extender using mywifiext.net. I hope this video was useful for you. If you have any doubts or if your extender is still not working, then you can comment us. Thank you and have a blessed day.